Welcome, everyone. The Disneyland fanbase is so big and well-established that in this day and age, it's hard to stump the theme park fanatics on information they don't already know. But I'm going to take a crack at it. These are five things you didn't know about Disneyland. Number 5. The Semaphore. Walt Disney received lots of gifts from various people, and many of those gifts were placed in Disneyland. Things such as the Kalamazoo handcar at Main Street Station or Lafitte's anchor in New Orleans Square. But one thing that is always overlooked is the semaphore at the New Orleans Square Railroad Station. This semaphore in particular is an authentic antique, and it was given to Walt Disney as a gift from William White, the chairman of the Delaware and Hudson Railroad. It was once used by the D&H Railroad to signal train masters of a change in orders. Today, it is still in operation, and it's actually used to signal when a train is approaching. This is useful for the cast members that need to cross the railroad tracks here, because they are given plenty of time to clear the way. Number 4. Tunnels. There is conflicting information online as to whether or not Disneyland in California has underground tunnels, but one thing you might already know is that the Magic Kingdom at Walt Disney World does have tunnels called utilidors. However, it may surprise you to know that Disneyland does, in fact, have tunnels. They just don't interconnect the way they do in Florida. The largest tunnel under Disneyland stretches from the northwest corner of Buzz Lightyear's Astro Blasters and goes southeast to the other side of the Carousel Building. It was built for the 1967 New Tomorrowland project and was once a major thoroughfare for cast members looking to get to Fantasyland or Frontierland without being seen. There is also another underground tunnel underneath the Disneyland Railroad connecting two different sides of the old administration complex, and a tunnel on the border of Fantasyland and Frontierland, burrowed into the earthen berm that separates the two lands. These are only a few of the small list of tunnels the park has. Number 3. Interconnected waterways. When Disneyland was being designed, there were plans for various canals, rivers, and ponds to be dug into the park. The man in charge of overseeing construction was Admiral Joe Fowler, and he had the bright idea to interconnect all these waterways together so they act more like one large body, helping to prevent stagnation and fouling of the water. In the early days, these connections were easily seen above ground, but as the park expanded, the connections had to be placed in large pipes under the walkways. The best example is this canal that connected the Jungle Cruise to the Rivers of America. It became an underground pipe during the construction of the Swiss Family Treehouse in 1962. Number 2. New Orleans Square Main Kitchen. When you look at New Orleans Square from a distance, it appears to be a series of buildings in close proximity to each other. But what if I told you the entirety of New Orleans Square is actually one giant building? You see, it all begins with a massive basement that was dug out. A little over half of the basement was reserved for the underground portion of Pirates of the Caribbean, but the other half was intentionally constructed to house a massive kitchen that could supply the southwestern side of Disneyland with the food supply it needs at the restaurants. Some restaurants in the park do not have kitchens large enough to do things like roasting meats, cooking soups, and making desserts, so park designers had the foresight to construct a massive kitchen underground that could help carry the load. The shops and eateries at ground level were simply built on top of the basement. So in essence, the entire thing is actually one giant building. Even the streets you walk down are not sitting on actual soil. Number 1. Main Street Station. I get asked a lot about which areas of the Disneyland Railroad still pass along the original route that was constructed in 1955. You see, over the years, the park had to be expanded from its original 60-acre plot to the 97 acres it occupies today. This means the railroad that surrounded the perimeter needed to be realigned. To this day, the only area of track that still runs along the original route is the short segment of track at Main Street Station. Another little fun fact is that the original passing tracks are still at the station. And you can also see the original rock ballast, which Walt Disney insisted was crushed to 5/8 scale to match the small scale of his trains. The practice of crushing the ballast smaller was eventually discontinued soon after the park opened, as the tiny gravel often got washed away in heavy rain. But the last remnants are still there, over 6 decades later. Well folks, that was 5 things you didn't know about Disneyland. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like to help the channel out. Subscribe for more unique content. I'd like to hear some more things most people don't know about Disneyland. Be sure to tell me in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and I hope you all have a magical day.
Thank you.